Now, what is the problem? There has been an increase of railway track during the past few years, but that increase has been really small. Number two, that the railway is number one losing both the passengers and goods, which affect not only the earning of the parks and railways. So these passengers and these goods are they basically contribute to the earning of the parks and railway. So it is losing that. And number two, it is making difficult for people to transport bulky items from one place to another. Railway is the most cheapest and most effective way of transporting bulky items. But if you don't have a properly working railway station or a railway system, then it is going to be a problem because you won't be able to transport the bulky items. Now, during 2011, it was decided to stop most of the goods trains due to severe shortage of locomotives and fuel. So when these locomotives were getting short, then what they did was that they decided to stop them, right? Because they were not working properly. Now the condition is so bad that about 115 railway services have been cancelled by the Pakistan Railways in the last 2 years. So much of our railway services are not working right now. Now let's talk about the airways. So air transport is most effective, but for smaller goods, right? So smaller but expensive and perishable goods. Bulky goods cannot be transported through air transport. And then the plus point is that it allows overseas trips because a railway station or a railway line will not allow for overseas trip, unlike the airways. Now, let's talk about PIA or Pakistan International Airline. This is the national airline. Now, for years, it remained the only airline which connected the country and also operated internationally. However, during 1990s, the industry saw growth when private airlines started operations. So this was the government airline. With time, there were some private airlines which came into the field, and we are going to discuss about those private airlines in a while. So PIA competed quite well with these airlines. So these are some of the private airlines: Airblue, Shaheen, and Boja Air. And then we have the PIA, which is a government airline as well. Okay? So the major airlines in Pakistan are these four. All these airlines have international routes. So all of these airlines help in the transport of people and the goods and items from Pakistan to other parts of the countries. The major airports in Pakistan are Jinnah International Airport in Karachi, Allama Iqbal International Airport in Lahore, Benazir International Airport in Rawalpindi, Bachra Khan International Airport in Peshawar, and Quetta International Airport in Quetta. Now let's talk about the sea routes. Waterways such as rivers, seas, and oceans, they're all important for transporting bulky goods. So railways and the sea routes are those routes which can help in the transport of bulky goods. The rivers have not been developed as waterways, even though we have a proper Indian system, we have the rivers, but still, unfortunately, those rivers have not been developed as waterways. The only, but we do have the seaports, however, handle most of the international trade. So since seaport is connected to the Arabian Sea, which can allow transport to different countries in the world, so this basically mostly helps in the international trade and less in the local trade. So the major seaports of Pakistan are Kemari Seaport, commonly known as Karachi Seaport, Port Qasim in Karachi, and Gwadar in Mehran Coast. So this is how the seaport looks like. Now there are many wharves. So wharf is basically this landing stage. So when a ship comes, then all the things from the ship can be unloaded over here. And if they want to put something in the ship, then everything can be loaded over here. So this place where the ship lands for the loading and unloading is basically called a wharf. Now, the Pakistan National Shipping Corporation works for the development of the maritime shipping industry and improvement of ocean transport services. So this is the name of the authority which is responsible for the improvement of ocean transport service. Kemari Seaport and Port Qasim link several international seaport destinations with Pakistan. So the two major seaports we have, they are called the Kemari Seaport and Port Qasim. Now, what are the benefits of seaport? Now, when we're talking about the benefits of seaport, let's talk about CPEC. So CPEC is something that has been introduced. And CPEC, what exactly are the benefits of CPEC? So Pakistan has a border with China. in the northwest, Afghanistan in the west, India in the east, Iran in the southwest, and the Arabian Sea in the south. So you see that Pakistan has a very strategic position. So it has a connection with the Arabian Sea. It has Afghanistan over here, China over here, India over here, and Iran over here. So it is connected to a lot many countries. So it has many land relations, and also it has a connection with the sea as well. So it has such a good position that it will allow for the trade with different countries through land and also to different parts of the world through the Arabian Sea. Now, Pakistan also serves as a transit route to non-coastal countries. Now, there are some countries which do not have any sea route. They are not connected to any sea, like Afghanistan, right? So if Afghanistan wants to have a trade with other countries, with other parts of the world, then for that, if it will transport the things to airport, then it will be quite expensive. So it can basically, since it's connected to Pakistan, so Pakistan can help it with the trade. So Pakistan also serves as a transit route to non-coastal countries, many countries in Central Asian state, and Afghanistan to trade by providing smooth access to worldwide market by the Arabian Sea. Then once the CPAC will allow for development of a long road between the country in China to the Gwadar, then this will allow an easy transport of cargo from China to Gwadar and from Gwadar to different parts of the world through the Arabian Sea. Now, this is going to decrease the trade cost of China and Pakistan and bring about a change in the modes of transportation, since through CPAC, a lot of infrastructure will be brought in Pakistan in terms of, like, there will be better gas pipelines, there will be a hydroelectric power station which will be built along this route as per the plan, and there will be a proper road system and airport. Now, this will enhance the economic cooperation with the world's biggest trading country. So China is one of the world's biggest trading company. So when we will develop this bond or this bond of trade with China, then it will help in the economic growth of Pakistan, right? So through the CPAC, it basically aims to develop infrastructure in Pakistan by first making this long road, and then airport, hydroelectric power, and gas pipeline throughout this route. So CPAC is basically called the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. So these infrastructure projects are still under construction. Now let's get on to the questions. So if somebody asks you what is infrastructure, you should be able to explain that infrastructure is any physical or any soft infrastructure which basically allows the service and the service for the better and effective growth of a country, right? Now, which of these infrastructures could you more easily get along without? So for example, this culture and recreational is something that we can, that's not a good idea to leave, but this is something that is still, that is something that you can still leave, because this isn't something that is as important as a proper water system, as a proper energy system, and a proper transport system. But yes, it is very important because it is for the physical fitness and a better psychological health of the people. Now, which of these infrastructures are more important to our community? So the success criteria is that you should talk about the social services like schools, universities, and hospitals. Hospitals are important for the better health facilities and for the better health of the people. School and universities basically make sure that there's a proper growth in education and people are more literate. Then security by military, so that ensures that your country is safe, the place where you live in is safe, and then transportation will help flourish the growth of the industries. So you can discuss that in detail. Please add more, because I've discussed all of these things in the previous slides. What is the current condition of our local infrastructure? So, you know, if you talk about infrastructure in Pakistan, especially in other parts of Pakistan other than Punjab, you see that there's a lot of electricity shortage. There's a lack of proper water. The water is not usually clean, and this basically causes a lot of waterborne diseases. Then you have a sanitation problem. There are no proper sewage systems, lack of proper medical facilities in our countries. You can witness that right now. During this corona outbreak, you know that we don't have enough ventilators in our country. You can discuss the current situation as well, right? So that would be really good if you discuss about coronavirus especially. Now, above all, the increase in population to an alarming level is making our problem worse, because we have increase in population, but we don't have enough facilities to compensate for that increased population. Now, name the important international airports of Pakistan. We discussed that in the previous slide. Name the major seaports of Pakistan and discuss the benefits. So, using that the information from the previous slide, we'll be able to name the major seaports. But when we talk about importance of the benefits of seaports, then you can, you know, because you have to talk in keeping in view the current situation of Pakistan, then please do talk about CPEC, because CPEC is going to help Pakistan grow, and that's because many world powers, you know, they're attracted to Pakistan because of its strategic location. I already told you that it is connected to different countries and to the Arabian Sea as well. So this is a very good position for any trade to take place. Then we also have many energy reserves in Pakistan. For example, in Balochistan, we have a lot of energy reserves. Then Pakistan also serves as a transit route to non-coastal countries. For example, we have Afghanistan, which has no land, which has no sea route, so we can help them carry out trade. Now, give reasons for the need of trade infrastructure for the growth of an economy in relation to seaports.